LeBron James scored 51 points. 51 points. Only six humans on Earth have ever scored 50 in an NBA Finals game. Ever. And that's not the story. LeBron was, by the way, the only one of those six humans to score 50 in an NBA Finals game and lose. But that's not the story. The Warriors, who looked so invincible coming into this series that Vegas gave them the best odds to win a title in the last 16 seasons, were largely very ordinary for most of this game. They were not able to trigger their usual third quarter of doom. But that's not the story. Oh no, my friends. The story is how a game that started at tip-off with Cavaliers owner Dan Gilbert first lavishly praising and then actually subtweeting his star player over comments LeBron had made about a nine-month-old trade ended with Tristan Thompson ejected, Cavs coach Ty Lue saying his team was, quote, robbed by the officials, Kevin Love fending off calls for his suspension for leaving the bench inappropriately. By the way, he will not be suspended for that. And J.R. Smith maintaining that he did, in fact, know the score in the final seconds of regulation, but wasted them anyway? I mean, personally, I find J.R. to be one of the more fun characters in the game. I mean, who hasn't thrown soup at one of their friends? But this was not a good moment for him. With the score tied and 4.5 seconds on the clock, JR grabbed a rebound, and instead of going for what looked like it would have been a relatively easy game-winning basket, he dribbled out toward the three-point line. LeBron starts wildly gesturing him to turn around, which was caught as this freeze frame. And well, you know the internet, that turned into this, and this, and this. Yeah. After time expired, you could see JR saying what seemed to be, quote, I thought we were up. And if in fact, lip reading, that's true, it would not be the first time JR forgot the score of a game in a key moment. Back when he was with the Knicks, he shot the ball at the end of the game when he definitely should not have, and later admitted he had the score wrong in his head. He even tweeted, quote, boneheaded play, slander well deserved. This time, though, JR told reporters he did know the score was tied and he was looking for LeBron and to call a timeout. I can't say if his teammates believed him, but the Warriors didn't seem to. Here was Draymond Green.
I mean, you got to know the score. That's just kind of basketball. Like, you got to know if you're winning or losing or tied. So
he was in there saying that I knew it was tied and I was... So I'm just wondering, knowing it was tied, how would you now observe what you saw in that situation?
I don't know.
I guess that further goes along with my theory. I thought he was looking for LeBron. Yeah. I would have looked for LeBron, too. Yeah.
Kevin Durant, at least a little more kind, saying, quote, I can't talk about a guy or a situation in that way because I do some dumb stuff on the court, too. Coach Ty Lue just seemed stunned. He was much more angry about some key late officiating calls and at the overall opportunity that was lost. If the Cavaliers were going to steal a game here in Oakland, I mean, this was probably it. Andre Iguodala was out, injured. The Warriors were out of rhythm after a tough Western Conference Finals. LeBron was rested. Instead, they walk away down 1-0 thanks to a bizarre series of events despite a historic performance from LeBron. And maybe we shouldn't be that surprised, actually. After all, that is the story of this season's Cleveland Cavaliers. Just all in one game.